I can't believe I listened to 3 hours, 42 minutes, and 18 seconds of this absolute garbage for you guys, but that's why I love you so much. Let me start off with this. They don't want you to be healthy, because if you were healthy, they wouldn't be making any money. This whole podcast is orchestrated, scripted, and intended to be inconclusive. Maybe we should get Frankie Boy to argue with a vegan on the Joe Rogan podcast. Would be one hell of a show, and other carnivores have had their chances already, not illustrating any knowledge or research whatsoever. Send Joe a tweet or message on Instagram, leave a comment on the YouTube debate. That being said, let's get started with this nonsense. Overall, this podcast was James Wilkes arguing and talking over Chris Kresser in a very aggressive tone, Joe not being a great moderator, and Chris not speaking up for himself. Pretty clear what happened here. Joe got a fat ass check from Big Broccoli, or he took a beating from a long cucumber after him and Chris trash talked the documentary last week. Starting off, James Wilkes appeals to the authority of the American Dietetic Association, Heart Association, you know, talking about how all of these experts in their field are saying that a plant-based diet is the best. The science, the consensus, points to a health foods plant-based diet being what is healthy. For the first half hour, they went back and forth on this nonsense dairy study, but the truth is, we shouldn't be looking at epidemiological studies for results. We should look at the mechanisms in those studies to see what's happening. For instance, if someone smokes cigarettes and gets lung cancer, we can hypothesize that the cigarettes are causing oxidative stress in the lungs. You know, look at the mechanism, look where inflammation is caused, and figure it out from there. After that first hour of nonsense, Joe hypothesized that since people are dairy intolerant, perhaps that could cause cancer by, you know, having inflammation in the digestive tract. Chris immediately goes back saying there's no mechanism in which dairy would cause prostate cancer. And I've said in this past video, Chris Kresser is very intelligent and simply holding back his true knowledge. For the next 30 minutes, it was an argument about what actually constitutes a low carbohydrate diet. You know, that studies done on low carbohydrate diets are usually 40 to 70% carbs, but compared to the average person eating even higher than that, it's why they are called low carb diets and used in studies. These two really like going back and forth, mincing words, interrupting each other, really dragging this out. Nothing is being said here. Chris brings up a good point that I always talk about. Are people eating meat in the form of McDonald's cheeseburgers, or are they eating a grass-fed steak with local vegetables? Are they following a standard American diet or a high-quality whole foods-based diet? And at this point, I noticed Chris was wearing an Apple Watch. At least, I think it was an Apple Watch. This got me curious. If Chris Kresser doesn't acknowledge the Wi-Fi concerns when wearing a device like that all day, perhaps he isn't as smart as I thought he was. They babbled on about heme iron for a bit, kind of ironic considering that just about every vegan is anemic, yet claims they get enough iron on their vegan diet. And then at this point, they made two very important observations. One is that food quality is important. Two is that an omnivorous diet is ideal for health. Let's see if they get more into this. Of course, we have to talk about the nonsense B12 argument that the only reason meat has B12 is because animals are given B12 supplements. Comical stuff. We know that conventionally raised animals require supplementation as they are not on their natural diet. Chris did make an incorrect statement, you know, saying that B12 wasn't fed to cattle, and James made him admit he was wrong in a fairly humiliating fashion. But for them to even let James run with this and not really crucify conventionally raised animals leads me to believe they weren't allowed to really speak negatively so much about this feedlot meat. I just can't believe that this English bellend is doubling down on the B12 in dirt and water nonsense. He tried to bring up a study where vegetables had B12 on them. Yeah, because you probably put human doo-doo on those vegetables to fertilize them, and poo-poo has B12. Mr. Wilkes repeats what was said in the film, that water and soil have chlorine and fluoride in it, you know, as modern disinfectants, which kills bacteria. But many countries don't use these chemicals in the water or agriculture, so that doesn't add up. And chlorine doesn't kill everything in the water unless you add incredibly large amounts to it. It doesn't make any sense. Chris got crucified in this B12 argument because he didn't really have any solid counters. James brought up a study where they took plasma B12 levels and, you know, vegans and vegetarians were fine. Chris didn't really call out that plasma B12 isn't indicative of tissue levels and is a very poor measurement. He did, however, bring it up when he talked about homocysteine, holotranscobalamin, there being other better markers of B12 deficiency, explaining how far more vegans and vegetarians are B12 deficient, but he said it, you know, fast in a pretty soft voice, and it was complex verbiage. James literally steamrolled over this, completely ignoring it, and moved on to another simplistic argument. But this is a large issue with everything. You know, Chris would have had to explain what homocysteine is, the methylation cycle, all of these things, and it's far too complicated to illustrate to an audience in most cases. Their conclusion, and even Joe Rogan agreed, that everyone should supplement vitamin B12, but what no one spoke about was that even vegans with B12 supplementation have high homocysteine levels, poor methylation, and aren't absorbing the B vitamins. It makes sense as to why people think vegetables are good for you, you know, why people are going vegan, why the diet has so much momentum. The loudest voice in the room is the one that tends to be heard, not the smartest voice. This ties in with epidemiology as well. Big agriculture makes money off of plant products. Therefore, there are ample studies supporting that, you know, from which simplistic summaries can be taken from much easier. There are meat industry Cargill and Tyson funded studies, but those are not as ample. It's why the Cargill carnivores are able to steal my information while ignoring and silencing me. It's very discouraging the amount of money that is behind keeping the population sick, uneducated, uninformed, and most importantly, it's preventing people from being happy and healthy, which is my goal and the reason I'm making this video, the reason I do everything I do every day that I don't want to do. When talking about homocysteine, Chris should have brought up that vegans have higher rates of stroke, but he might not have been aware of that. I have several videos on which I explain the mechanism. I can't believe that Chris lost this ridiculous argument in front of millions of people, or that it was scripted to do so and he accepted that. This vegan should put his clown shoes back on and squeeze into an electric car. Chris was asked if he would choose a vegan diet or a carnivore diet, and he chose vegan, but said it kind of like reluctantly, swallowed while he was saying it, said I'd be worried about nutrient deficiencies. I don't think that was what he really wanted to say. I feel like James Wilkes has a gun under the table pointed at each of their crotches. James continues to appeal to authority, mentioning these leading experts of these dietetic associations. But we know half of these studies were written by the Seventh-day Adventist Church, who have religious beliefs in vegetarian and vegan diets. You know, ties to the American Heart Association can be made as well. You know, James had the nerve to call out Chris Kresser for selling animal-based products, protein powder supplements on his website, yet his documentary, The Game Changers, was produced by James Cameron, Jackie Chan, and had Arnold Schwarzenegger in it. Really? Isn't this guy pushing his luck a little too far? Putting the vegan golden boy on the Joe Rogan podcast make him look good. If you guys haven't seen James Wilkes on some UK TV shows, he was crucified by Piers Morgan. James keeps talking about his nutrition research, his team, his advisors, how much he studies this information, but it's all nonsense. You might as well be reading children's coloring books if you have that much bias and that much big broccoli funding behind you, because the literature is garbage and biased. I don't understand why this vegan moron keeps bringing up that Chris's studies are industry funded so that they are invalid when he literally has a golden cucumber dildo up his tushy this whole debate. If you want to discredit industry funding, just about everyone at every single government organization should be losing their job, including the American Dietetics Association and the American Heart Association and all of these scientific bases that these vegans use to justify their position. It's funny how people say we should listen to the government about diet, yet if you told people to appeal to authority, listen to government about anyone else, they are a bunch of incompetent dimwits, yet we're praising doctors and these dietetic organizations that have control of our health and are using it to their advantage to make money, those sweet Tyson and Cargill Benjamins. Yeah, bro. 5G is good for you. Plug me in, baby. And then James actually brings up the nonsense study, Position of the Academy of Nutrition and Dietetics, which was written by your boy himself, Winston J. Craig, the Seventh-day Adventist demon. But hey, if your vegan diet is appropriately planned, you might not kill your baby. And hey, Frankie boy, why aren't these other carnivores talking about this? Because it compromises their special interest funding. I can't stand this appeal to authority bullshit. You know, James kept saying that eating animal foods was not the scientific consensus. It's not the scientific consensus. It's not the scientific consensus. It's not the scientific consensus. Yeah, buddy, keep starving yourself on that vegan diet and your hair might grow back like a chia pet. Tweedledum starts talking about protein on a vegan diet. You know, they start arguing about protein in a peanut butter sandwich versus a steak. Like, who cares? Chris didn't have the opportunity to speak against this, but I explained in my Cam Newton video, paper value doesn't matter. Plant-based protein sources do not provide the body with adequate amino acids for the Krebs cycle. For the urea cycle, animal foods have a certain amino acid profile that cannot be replicated. And yeah, let's just keep ignoring that every athlete that goes vegan falls apart and retires within a year or loses their mind. Then he had the nerve to say that additional protein intake doesn't improve muscle mass or strength gains. Is that why every vegan male is a soy boy wet noodle, except for the ones injecting them with steroids? I'm a little disappointed, and I can't believe they didn't bring up fat-soluble vitamins. Very strong arguments can be made against, you know, the bioavailability of vitamin A, K2, D3, omega fatty acids, even certain, just about every mineral and element, actually, in animal foods versus plant foods. I can't wait until everyone goes vegan, feels like crap, start shitting their brains out and injecting themselves with animal vitamins, all because mainstream media pushes it as an agenda. But people feel like such garbo on a standard American diet, you know, who knows how they're gonna feel in comparison. There is no other carnivore with hundreds of educational videos, I'd have well over 1,000 if I didn't delete them, and thousands of hours of research specific to the carnivore diet. Other less experienced carnivores have been on the Joe Rogan Experience with little success. They are getting on these podcasts because they have special interest funding. Perhaps it's time for a change to better the health of everyone. And the only hope I have is my viewer base sharing my information, because all of these people, all of these special interest groups are trying to censor me as much as possible for telling the truth, using ad hominems to discredit me, ignoring me, whatever they can do, because they're losing money. Thank you guys for joining me. If you could please, you know, as I said, share the video, like the video, subscribe, you know, just visit my channel every day, leave a comment down below. If you guys do want to support me further, you can check out Frankie's Free Range Meat, the most affordable animal products online. And the reason we do that is because we don't make half as much money as any of these other meat companies that are scamming you and gouging you and misleading you on their products. You can also go to Frankie's Naturals for minimal ingredients, minimally processed hygiene and cosmetic products. If you do want to reach out to me, check out frank-tofano.com for my carnivore video course. That is about 10% of the price of what these people are charging you to join some exclusive meat club. Thanks again for joining me, guys. Enjoy the rest of your day. We're doing a live stream later, live critique, vegan 2019. I'm gonna burn my eyes out.